the illusions
Team
at least.
Secrets turn to ban.
The bounty anyway.
Yeah.
I think it's just gonna run at them, make sure that IO can't stack up the jungle, and just take control of that mid lane very early with the Nature's Prophet and the Bounty Hunter coming in. I think they're focusing a lot of effort on that lane.
I think they actually pick it now because they probably realize that it's going to be Spiritbreaker, most likely, I guess, off lane at this point, right?
You can easily have them babysit the Invoker in the safe lane.
Yeah.
It's not that big a deal. I mean, you're versus the Nature's Prophet. I doubt it's A-OK.
I think it just depends. Are there any offlaners that would be really valuable right now? Or Team Secret? Void's not bad.
What about Tide?
But
yeah,
I think it's a bit slow.
Tide's pretty good. Yeah.
We did it. Getting against played. PL.
Yep.
Mm-hmm.
And they're pretty much... I think they got an okay amount of nuke damage, I guess. They have single target.
You want some sort of AoE setup for Pennywhist to be able to win.
I think the Tidehunter is too long of cooldown. I think when, like, when they run it, they actually want like shorter duration, or shorter cooldown ultimate to set up for West Tiny. Sometimes you'll see Centaur, sometimes you'll see LC, sometimes you'll see Magnus, Tidehunter, like all of these kind of work. Batrider
actually
also.
LC is really good against that.
Yeah,
game.
I think LC is actually the best of these. It's also really good at clearing PL illusions.
Yeah, for sure.
But it's not that great versus the bench because the defense is
well. Yeah, it pulls you a little bit out of position, but I don't think it's actually that bad, like most of the time.
Like land and invoker combos, you want the dual target.
it's insane.
You're done for.
Yeah, in this lineup, you actually wouldn't need that much farm priority to get kills. Any combo and invoker, you're just dead. Like, can't live through that.
I think part of the reason why they took the back anyways, even though the Spirit Breaker's good. Part of it is like Spirit Breaker's so tanky, he doesn't really care about back clicking him a nuisance. But I think if you're a team that Phoenix and remaining. You don't have a super veteran captain, you're just gonna stick to stuff that you practice no matter what. You're not gonna force your team to unknown waters and say, hey guys, they banned out our strats, let's do something a little different here that fits them. Or just do what we know, make them play around us, not the way around.
Yeah, that's true.
Is it still really is Bounty Hunter still really relevant in terms of like if you're fighting a lot and trading?
Yeah, it's their point.
Yeah, and an MVP are always going to trade if they take fights.
Yeah,
they will eventually get a kill. So
it's even like good
it's
against
like a safety net.
Yeah, it's good against the Wisp too because oftentimes like the Tiny and the Wisp are just somewhere off on the map and the Bounty can hunt them all the time, look for potential teleports and kill the Wisp. Like very easy for the blow up Wisp, like a Shuriken, a magic missile, and a lance, and that hero's freaking dead. Not really much you can do about it, but some sustain now for Secret. They get Dazzle.
The Secret team looks scary. On
10 seconds,
doesn't feel like MVP are gonna have a great time running at them at all.
I think that they did a pretty good job of adapting. Honestly, Secret, they have a lineup now that's not really cooldown reliant. Like they don't need to wait for anything except for pretty much just the IO hitting six. Now the MVP win the game by that point.
Who's this guy?
Back. His name.
Yeah.
Mm.
Core
is
Lesh.
Is this another first? Is the first Lesh? It is, right?
Yeah. Huh? Alright, and these guys will get ready. Puppy just sat back down, and they'll be getting into the game momentarily, and refer it to the commentators. But before we do, we're going to ask our two couches if they still kind of stick with their picks from earlier, or if you would like to kind of be swayed by the draft. So,
we're sticking.
Maybe, because I was like, secret all the way in with this draft.
We're sticking, dude.
Alright, he's coerced me. The weird thing is, I'm the MVP fan, and I was gonna go secret.
Why do you stop believing, dude? They're on a roll. It's 3-0. They have core less. They don't even care. God, they have no fear. They just pick whatever they want. Anything.
Alright. Staying with it.
Yeah, I'm gonna stick with secret again.
Yeah, you think it's just much better draft?
Well, again, I think it's really important when you're playing against MVP to always be able to fight at any point, so, yeah.
Oh, for the Bounty Hunter, that's a great idea.
Oh, good luck, have fun, have been called. So we're going to go into the next match, a huge match for MVP and also Secret. Remember, if Secret lose this, they'll have to play again today, and fatigue can really kick in the group stages, so they're going to want to tie this one up and take it out. But we'll go over to the commentators, get ready to see the results of the game, really. Let's just watch the game. I don't know what I'm doing, Cap. Thanks.
So eloquent and stylish, James. Thanks for the handoff, and welcome back. I'm Tubby One. I'm here with Cinderin as we'll take you through MVP versus Team Secret. MVP, they've had three games, and well, it may not even be a surprise. I don't think we've even clocked an hour worth of in-game time for their three games so far. And
I mean, that is a surprise. It's not a surprise. It's already not to be a surprise anymore that they do it when you do it over and over again. But I have higher hopes of Secret this game. I think they got a way better draft against what MVP have than in the previous one. And I'm just happy we get to see Lishrak. I actually think this hero is a bit forgotten. Of course, he got nerfed quite a lot. But can definitely still work. I think Alliance had quite a bit of success with it in Captain's Draft. Granted, there's different, but still.
Yeah, they've been running him in mid. Well, we start off the same way we started Kindle 1. A bottom rune fight going off. Maybe get a lot of early information. They keep throwing these stuns out. The Sunstrike, though, gonna hit pretty nicely into MP. Puppy, he's already pretty low, but the first blood's got this Lishrak that will drop us. Puppy to follow directly after. Misery's got charge in 2 seconds' time, and this will allow him to catch up to Zubu. Even with the Fairy Fire, this will not be able to save the Vengeful Spirit unless he can get a perfect block stun. Not gonna happen. Pilot Eye's last attack will kick in. So this time, it seems Secret take the, well, in a way, the advantage from the fight because they get first blood and 2-1, but they're still taking some time to get into their lanes.
And they didn't get any bounty runes, so overall it's fairly even. Yeah, since it's taking them longer to get into lanes, this might actually favor MVP. It's pretty close regardless, which is obviously way better for Secret than what happened in the last game, so better start. You made alright, never mind. They are not off to a better start. They are not used to playing against Bounty Hunter anymore, and they get their Curious Knight between the two towers mid, so
at least it didn't have anything vital on it. Like, that's the upside. Like, had just a TP scroll on it.
Yeah, Pi nothing gets his more. Bottle. I think, did they ferry that in with the...
It came through Puppy.
Dazzle? Yeah, he carried it in. Okay. Then not to me. If the bottle is on that, that is game-losing stuff. You lose 3 minutes of momentum in mid lane.
Oh, Febby? He just walks straight underneath the tower. Orb of Venom takes the aggro from the tower. For Rev, the damage is actually going to be enough. The Sunstrike kicking in from Weeha. He looks for the revenge. That's on top of Febby. For Rev, just going to TP himself out here. The Spirit Breaker charges a little bit too far away. I think Febby realizes he is definitely dead. Puppy will take the solo kill on that one. But again, Weeha starting off the game with a death. Not the dream for him, at least.
Yeah, very good trade for MVP. Giving us a port away. Again, they seem to be focusing Weeha very much so far. I don't know if they're focusing the player or the hero, but Invoker in the previous game got run over in lane, this time off to a bad start as well. And similar to last game, Kyo in the mid lane not being pressured nearly as much, and it's just the nature of Secret's lineup. IO Tiny is not very good at pressuring a PL super early on. Gonna start getting difficult once Tiny gets a few levels.
They have a sentry over on Puppy. They're gonna throw it down, looking for that kill over on Febby. Febby's almost out of range for Sunstrike! Oh, he only just barely missed. The charge comes in from Misery, but well, he only gets the initial hit. He's gonna bash Febby! He walked back in range of the sentry ward! Team Secret will take the aggro from the Aegis to drag him away.
How cocky can
Febby
you be?
Is trying to deny himself at the moment.
He already knew they had a sentry because he was getting hit after the charge. And he still chooses to walk back in. Well, now he should definitely know where that sentry is.
But he wanted to die. I think QR is looking to do a bottle refresh, so the bounty will TP in a moment. That's why QR was spamming out everything he's got to drop Highlight Eye down, but it's... I don't know. The spam just isn't really good enough. He has to wait another 3 seconds till his TP's back off cooldown. And there's that stacking the panel was talking about in the jungle. Pairing for the flash farm of Eternal Envy.
Got one. Is that one double stack only so far?
Yeah only one.
Yeah. Well, it's 3 minutes in, so there's still plenty of time before he actually.
They're going again on top. We have this time. This time he's out of range of the tower, but Ferev's got Puppy to deal with. But they don't have another sentry ward in order to get the vision, so Weeha dropping down, but obvious Puppy's gonna keep him up.
But MVP are... What I really like about their playstyle so far is that they're emphasizing aggression. They want to make moves all the time and force Secret to rotate. And even if they don't find kills, Secret have to, you know, play their game. And it prevents them from stacking very much. It keeps them on their toes and they don't get to get into their comfort zone, which is, Secret are good at playing a slower early game and just building up. But they're definitely not letting them do this. It seems very deliberate against the team to, from MVP to do that. I guess they did it against EOM too. Maybe they just do it every game. I don't know. So far so good, right?
It's the classic, just keep going at them so you can't get a rhythm in. Like, isn't this what you're meant to be doing with the offlaners in this current meta anyway? Like, you're always trying to keep the attention to the offlane so the ports can't attack into the mid, but MVP that is attacking everywhere, just like bottom lane. TP in, but some hits, the Sprout holds him in, and there goes Misery.
And there goes the tower. This is a safe lane Lishrak, Diabolic Edict, the best ability in the game to push towers with early.
One interesting choice as well that he actually goes for that over something like the Lightning, because you could have just played the lane harassment, but knowing you've got a Nature's Prophet, you level up the Split Earth, you level up the Edict, and you know it's all about the push. And he even puts now the third point up into Diabolic Edict. There is no way to stop this.
I like this choice so much simply because Secret are not fighting ready. They can't do
again?
Anything. Oh no.
Again? This time it actually has something bigger and it had Puppy's Boots on it. It has smoke, it has dust, it has an Observer Ward.
Oh boy.
This is the kind of stuff that's got to send you to a tilt. Yep. And you're losing your bottom tier 2 tower as well. You're gonna burn your fortification.
2 couriers lost, 2 towers lost, and there's no reason for MVP to not just continue. The Dazzle support is not strong right now. The IO support is not strong right now. Spirit Breaker is level 2. Tiny's level 4. They can actually just, I think they could literally just go 5-man mid and take this tower as well with very little risk. If they get any sort of pick-off, tower's there. It goes so quickly that Secret will not even be able to respond. Good news for them, though, is that finally Misery gets some levels, right? Now they've pushed so many creeps into his base that this should get him at least level 4. So that's something.
That is definitely something.
But the Prophet's almost level 6, and that's the one you want to compare him to. Yeah. That hero's flat out just
Eternal Energy is dead. Yeah. The Whisper's TPing in right now. How quick can Highlight Eye get there? And, well, okay. They're actually going to have Puffy take some damage, but they're going to be okay. Highlight Eye still dealing with a massive TL illusions. But as you said, like, how do you even stop this kind of push from Team Secret? What real deep push have you got apart from a 2-2 combo for Eternal Envy? There's still a level 4 Tiny 6 minutes in. Again, it's now a level, like, it's a level 3 Diabolic Edict. They at least have their fortification to try and, like, slow down this push in the mid.
They should really use that while Edict is running. They use that kind of late. I guess it overlays more or less.
A little bit. Yeah, like, you maybe got like 1 second. Yeah. 1 second between when the Edict runs out and the fortification's still going.
Secret are not ready. I think I was going to say it was very good that they dodged that gank because it defended their tower.
Mm-hmm.
I'm not sure. Doesn't seem like it. They're tossing in creeps. It's the only way they can deal any damage right now to MP standing at the side. Pure.
Oh, look at that. The TP in from Forever, the back lines. He's trying to control up Highlight Eye so QR can keep the Lances flying. Pilot Eye is out of bottle charges, and he's actually tethered himself to Puppy of all players. Now, you've already lost your mid-tier 1 tower. The Sunstrike is going to be soaked up by Febby as well as QO. That's what keeps QO alive. But then they got another rune on bottom to pick up. And MVP just keep the rotations going. You've claimed 3 towers in 7 minutes. And again, MVP, they're ripping apart the net worth train. They have 5,000 net worth in 7 minutes. Yeah, the experience isn't as great, but they're getting so much money onto a team which is getting Bounty Hunter and Misery dead once again. MP actually delaying his stun. He started up the animation then realized that wasn't going to be the greatest thing in the world.
I think he cast Edict first.
Yeah, you're actually right. Yeah. He cast Edict first.
I don't think he needed it, but, you know, better safe than sorry, right? Just get the kill, done with it, and move on. And I think the next target's got to be top lane, and I don't see any reason to wait.
They're
here.
Going yep. again.
We have trouble. They do not have dust, actually. And they don't
damage.
Stop that. Oh.
That was close.
Alright, Courier's responsive, you know what to do.
You can finally get boots.
Yeah.
How you doing, Kenny? Kenny, where's the bounty? The bounty
he's
is...
already looking for
he,
it.
He's actually running over to where the stacks are, where Puppy is currently doing the big stacks too.
No, this is not.
Well, especially when it's a flying right, courier, and right. they're using speed. They've been so defensive with that courier.
Oh, if he can steal half the experience from this stack, he won't. He'll steal a quarter, but that's still really, really good. He can get in range. He's trying to hide in the side here.
Is he trying to frag that? Yeah, he's trying to stay
he
clear
wants to
of
not...
the ball.
Yeah, exactly.
He and he also doesn't know where the sentry ward is.
It's difficult for Secret. Oh, he's walking
Oh,
in.
He's almost going to kill Envy! Calamity right now. Team Secret lose 3. The bounty was lost as well. But who really cares? Team Secret, they're losing their cause. They're not getting everything they need. They've lost their tier 1 tower on top lane. And what stops MVP from just keeping on going?
Oh my god.
that I don't even know what to say. That's so unlucky. It's actually unbelievable. I mean, at least Envy died to the new trolls, right? He could have also died to the bounty, so it could have been even worse. But that one troll killing him off, and then tethering onto the cliff, getting stuck. They lose their power and almost the tier 2, yeah.
Doobie's gonna stop it. No, he actually gets bumped back by the charge. The Sunstrike's on target for forever, but only moves half the line, so VS goes down. And with the lands from QR, we slow down Pilot Eye enough. They haven't got the vision over on that Forev. They just prop it. So he's able just to run himself away. Middle tower is under attack. Meanwhile, Febby is now soaking up his level 6 on bottom lane. So all of these fights that have been happening, in under 10 minutes you've removed almost, like, there's still only two tier 2 towers left, and the top one's at half life. You've basically removed 4.5 towers from this map in under 10 minutes against Team Secret. But who says the Punetta is dead?
Yeah, they're just doing it in a very different way. It's kills into towers, and they don't even have that many kills, but they're just taking so much advantage of very small openings. Now it's gonna get harder, though. Secret has less towers to defend, so they can be more ready now in the right places, and they're getting their levels. The key abilities to get right now is obviously Tiny getting level 8, and maybe, I don't know if he's gonna get a blink after this drum.
I don't know if that's gonna be enough. Envy's dead again. With the stun, MP, look at the pulse, nope, it's going to work. Envy,
good
they
toss.
Throw him away, there's no lining his bomb down, and Misery charging his way forward. Going on the Boo-Boo, Puppy is here as well, but Misery, the Shallow Grave will let him keep fighting forever. He's going for the big hit, he's going after Eternal Envy, while Misery, the Shallow Grave finally wears down. Pilot Eye actually gets stunned up as well. His two heroes down for Secret. Weehaw's gonna follow it, so is Eternal Envy. Team Secret, they're staring down the barrel of a team wipe at the moment as Weehaw will go underneath the tier 2 tower just to die. Puppy, the only one to survive after he TP'd out. And MVP, they don't have to stop for anything, man. They just keep going. As it looks like the admin's actually asking for a pause for 1 minute as we have an error. What error?
Make sure MVP aren't cheating. Quickly pause the game, look through the game files. There's something wrong today with MVP.
Yeah,
do they have, like, does their team get, like, double gold or something? Oh, bottom line.
Yeah, they're not pausing. They keep going for it. Tossed up in towards the air. So at least they get some kind of kill here. And Puppy is now going to pause this. As Forev did go down, but the top tower is still being taken out.
It's the admin distraction strategy. They actually...
What is it? We're not back at Finale stage, man.
They got a kill on Forev, and then they paused. It's like, okay.
Okay. So, just a quick issue, but they can work through it. But MVP, man, what a run they're having at the moment. Like, they hold the top 3 net worths on the field. I don't even know how you kill off the Lashrak. Like, he's walking around with both a vid booster and a point booster. He's got so much life on this Lashrak that, like, Team Secret, they can't really answer it, because where does your damage come from? Not coming from an Invoker, because MVP targeted him again, so it's a 0-2 Invoker. And Eternal Envy, like, middle lane didn't work for him, the jungle worked against him. How do you battle? And Pilei Die can't help him out, like, all they can do is Shallow Grave, but seems to only delay the inevitable.
You're looking at Secret's lineup, and right now I think, like, 90% of their damage is magical. They have very little physical damage output that's any threat. So if you're MVP right now with this kind of lead, you can go into this Bloodstone with Lashrak, as it looks like, and you can just start pairing BKBs or just any sort of magic resistance. If you want to end the game early, you can get mech pipe. The bounty hunter should be able to get mech pretty early. You can look toward a pipe on the Nature's Prophet or vice versa if they want. Looks like it is the Orchid again that he built in the previous game as well. Think they have so many options at this point. When you have so much map control minute 11, it's so difficult to lose the game. Like, mm-hmm. you almost need to actively try to overextend to put yourself in a bad position, because you can, as long as you have map control in the enemy jungle, you have a bounty hunter scouting out for you, you can just play safe and play a farming game as well and just out farm them. Secret will be so scared of moving out anywhere because they can't see bounty, they know Prophet will be joining if there's any fight breaking out, so they're always plus 2 up.
I'm wondering if you even have to, like, if that's a risk that MVP shouldn't take, like, to go back and play the farming style.
Oh, I don't think they should. I think they should. They're doing well with this, yeah. So why not?
Yeah. Especially, like, what happens if you do give, like, Invoker space? Like, he picks up, like, he's got his Midas, so at least he's farming, like, slightly efficiently from that. But if Tani does get a couple of kill combos, MVP are worth a lot if they can be killed. Then, yeah, they have a risk, but at this point, they look unkillable, so if they run up, they take a rack. Like, I know we're only 12 minutes into the game, and we're already thinking about what if MVP pushing through the top.
Oh yeah, there's track too.
Yep. You got track, you got no relocate available. Pile I just used this, so there's no saving grace on that one. Nether Strike's on cooldown for 25 seconds. The Dazzle doesn't even have weave, so you don't even worry about the armor shift. I don't think you worry about anything really coming out from the Dazzle, because eventually you're going to find the kills anyway.
You're definitely not pushing until you have profit, though. Like, going 4 yeah, and 5 in the enemy base now is such a high...
So you just rotate into the mid lane, then. You take out the tier 2 tower, and that successfully removes all of secrets out of towers by 13 minutes.
That's fine. Then you can look for the Roshan, from like they did in the previous game, control that area, and then go from there. Looks like they might... Okay, this is very confident. I think they're going to back up.
It may just be trying to force secret to defend, and yeah, that's all. I'll see what they've got up there at least.
They get a track out on the wisp, and now they're gonna rotate away. Another thing MVP can do if they want, they can buy a gem. It's a little bit high risk, you know, because then if they get caught with it, you give the enemy team a gem against your bounty, and that's obviously not that great. But at the same time, if they take full map, if they remove all secrets wards, nowhere is safe. Alright, this is a minute 12 bloods then.
Yeah. You want more records coming up on MVP? Like, last time it was QR on the PL that just, like, shredded it apart. Right now, MP is looking really damn good.
Yep. He is pretty farmed. Curious to see his next item. I think BKB is a very, very solid choice, like I mentioned earlier.
Mm-hmm.
If he wants to look to be, like, super stat efficient, you could think about something like... get a Shiva's Guard very early, you could go for an Axe if you really believe in the ultimate damage output. Blink Dagger isn't half bad either. So many choices that are good this game. The nice thing about Blink is that it makes it easier to split push, and you can always just avoid the relocate.
Mm-hmm.
There's a Spirit Breaker, that's like a wild card, so... see what he does. Very curious to see his build up.
He's always playing this so smart. Like, he understands the other lanes are not being defended right now. They also have an Observer Ward. It's fairly shallow. Considering their current position with the towers down 13 minutes, it's a rather shallow ward inside the secret jungle. Don't get a lot of information out of that, but MP, like, the pressure starts up again. There is fortification from secret, but they don't have to burn it for this. Like, right now, Weeha probably believes he can defend this, but the creep wave is gone. But they keep poking and prodding and forcing more of Team Secret to retreat. Gives more and more space to cure, and he can just BT himself, and he bought boost of travel when he TP'd back to base previously. And, well, now Dazzle, is that puppy actually going to TP on the outside? Yeah, it is. So he TP's in around the back, throws out the weave. That tier 3 tower is almost dead. They didn't use fortification at all, but now they see more of Team Secret have come back. QO can be a little bit more aggressive on that bottom lane.
Yep, TP is enough information. Yeah, they almost got tier 3 for free. I think they can just chill, wait out the weave, and go again. It's expiring in like 3 seconds, so...
they also have the mech on
Very good timing.
Got to keep that in mind coming into this fight. So they've got the mech over on him, they've still got the VS swap, Misery charging himself forward, actually swaps the track out, which puts Dubu in a real world of hurt. Febby actually refuses to use the mech in this situation to save his VS. There's a lot of tracks up already in Team Secret, they're going to relocate out the track done instantly onto Weeha. They do not see Febby, however. The Observers and Sentry down for MVP, they trigger off the dust, that did actually hit the Bounty Hunter, throwing him down, so will the Ice Wall, he throws the Shuriken Toss down for the Relocate, drags him out, and another stun from MP, turning on the Pulse Nova, Eternal Envy, they have to kind of run away from this one, Pano will come back into the fight, but Misery, he's just melting, MP is so low on life, they do not want to lose him, and they're going to anyway, Dazzle gets 708 gold, 14 minutes in, Febby will actually go down as well, Puppy with double kill claiming, 1,000 gold for these two kills. And now QO, he comes to join the fight, and he'll look to take away the streak of Puffy. The Prophet's also going to TP into who kills Secures in the top of the riverside.
Damn, that attack from Puppy killing Lesh definitely caught Lesh by surprise. He took like 90 damage from a Dazzle right click. He's had so much minus armor from the Weave, so he didn't get to Bloodstone Suicide. It's a pretty good hold for Secret, I think. That's something their lineup is really good at. If they get ahead in a fight, they're so good at chasing. Spirit Breaker, IO, Tiny, obviously. Even the Invoker with the drum.
The big question for me right now is that tier 3 tower just looks so enticing. Is this actually baiting like MVP to push beyond their means at the moment? Like, we're still 15 minutes into the game trying to siege into a tier 3 tower. Like, it's a nice one over on Puppy. The Treants are doing some work, but the tower is still at 96 HP. The catapult is slowly actually winning this push for MVP. MVP is going to deny up the tower. and that they keep on going. There's no fortification available here for Team Secret, so the Edict will be pretty damn effective.
Good weave deployed here to Bounty and Lesh, so they're gonna wait. Henry was thinking about it.
But TP them again.
This track damage, Shuriken rather, is starting to become a problem.
Now he's also realizing another problem. That Orchid from Ferev's just arrived. A 16-minute Orchid up for Nature's Prophet, but MVP, it still feels like they're forcing the issue before they really have to. And you're seeing Weehan catching up in net worth. He's up to 7k gold net worth now for the Invoker. May not mean that much considering like MVP's pushing power, but Rubber Band could easily start snapping back in MVP's face.
I need to be a little bit careful. Still have a 7500 lead, but this item I think is the biggest pickup that Secret have had so far this game. I think the Blink Dagger and Tiny is really what can get the.
And they're gonna use it for. And he comes, Envy, walking it up. Duo actually dodges with a doppelganger, the charge, but he gets bounced back out. And Weehan then finishes the job. Now is Dubu, a perfect happening blast, catching out two MVP players. Febby, he's dusted up as well as a double kill for Weehan. And Team Secret, they are punishing MVP, and Envy just keeps going forward with the Avalanche Toss, Misery, okay, MP just wheels back in mid-air. All heroes down for MVP, and Team Secret now, how do you try and punish this? Think of Roshan, or do you think of Talus?
I think you get this mid-tier one. Well, they might actually not even have time for that, but the game is still so early, you get a team wipe, the heroes respawn after like 25 seconds, but
they could try for it. There is a glyph, they will be using that. I don't think Secret will get that this time around, but that Blink Dagger from Envy immediately paying off. I'm actually, you know,
coming in.
It's understandable that he went for the drum first, because he just wants to tank up and get some stat-efficient items, so they have a chance against MP's very quick aggression. But he just saw that Blink Dagger, maybe he should have got it before the drum. It just rushed Treads to Blink. Won them a fight single-handedly.
Well, it's less greedy than game one, still. Now, like, Team Secret. Okay, MVP are gonna smoke up as three. Duo is not being involved in this one, and neither is Ferev, but obviously Ferev can just TP in. He doesn't actually have his Wrath of Nature, as he does in 1 second time, so that just came off cooldown.
Ooh,
and
MV.
They find Eternal Envy. He walked into it, so the
time caught up,
and Eternal Envy is gonna go down.
45 seconds, no buyback. If they notice that, they might be able to just claim an objective. Yeah, they get
Roshan.
The question is if they wanted to try to defend that with a buyback if he had it, but now there's absolutely no doubt they can't contest it. It's a big, big win for MVP. Envy with a big play, and then with the... You can't really blame him for that. He walked up to his Secret shop.
Mm-hmm.
There's just so much pressure on the map now that it's difficult. Maybe you... If you send the courier, you know who's there. So, gotta get it somehow.
Now you get a second life on the track.
Yeah.
MP didn't have the greatest setup for pick up the Bloodstone, as he's now sitting at 5 charges only. But it's gonna get bigger as time goes on. Now he actually picked up an Aether Lens, his next major item.
Yeah, that is obviously a very good choice too after that Bloodstone.
Okay.
Can be in a much safer position and get the Splitter buff. I don't think it increases the AoE, the search range of Diabolic Edict. Having a lens, I have to admit I haven't played Drax since this item came out a single time, I think. But believe it shouldn't.
But if it does, let's just say it does, it's incredible. Perceiving powers, you just stand 200 extra range away and deal damage, that would be amazing.
I need to add in those little information things to the abilities. Each lens now increases the ability by this,
yeah.
Just like they do for the Aghanim Scepter. So looks like everybody's been listening to what you've been saying with the whole Secret is doing a crap ton of magical damage. I believe this is actually meant to be going into a pipe eventually. However, on the Vengeful Spirit. Because they've already got, obviously,
absolutely.
the bounty mech to go into Glyphs, so that makes a lot of sense. And yeah, the cloaks are actually flying out for both Febby as well as Dubu.
It's definitely the item to go for here. I was mentioning it earlier as a possible pickup Prophet, but if they can get it on Venge, then it's even better. Prophet can go for some stronger late game items or mid game items. And you can see MVP, they're showing some respect now.
Yep.
They're slowing down a little bit, even though they have the Aegis. If they had this Aegis 5 minutes ago, they would have just gone straight high ground and cleared. But now that, like, Secret has struck a little bit of fear into them, and they're at least not running at their tier 3s yet, so they get a little bit of a breather.
Well, they can wait for the next big core items, like the Lothrak going in for either Yule's or Scythe. Yeah, but the Yule's probably going to be a lot closer to it after they take out this mid tower, but Prophet needs another 1800 for his Aghanim Scepter, and the PL is pretty close to the Fusil. when I say pretty close, he has Diffuser Blade. They bought him time in the bottom lane to do such a thing.
Really puts it into perspective how fast he got it in the previous game. Now he got a 21-minute one, and they're doing really well, and he is farmed with the boots of travel.
Does he see Envy? When they put the Observer Ward down, they can see Eternal Envy.
Uh-oh.
The Wrath of Nature hits him, so he couldn't actually use his Blink Dagger straight away. The Orcs will connect as well. Can they actually get Norb? Relocate wasn't triggered, and Puppy couldn't get in range for the Shallow Grave.
There is a buyback, though. They're definitely going to force that.
If he uses his buyback, like, you're slowing down the Aghanim Scepter on the Tiny. I suppose you're only 21 minutes in, so it's not as expensive.
I think they're going to lose Rax if they don't. This 30-second window might be enough. A good thing for them is that they can do a very well-timed buyback together with Charge and Invoker, and then Envy can join in when they have to set up the fight, if he wants to. We'll see what they do.
Well, there's a fortification out from Secret, and that was used before Diabolic Edict was triggered. So now MP is just going to melt through the range for action. Yeah, Secret, they're letting it go. 8 seconds until MP's back up. Misery charging himself forward. The thing is also 2 minutes left on that Aegis Immortal, but the top rack is gone. MVP can just bail out of here and have no casualties. And really, is Envy going to get there in time? He doesn't TP himself forward. So they're waiting for MVP to overextend.
I think that was worth a buyback, honestly. I think they could have defended with a buyback, even against Aegis. And if they don't try to defend that and spend, I don't know, 500 gold on the Tiny to hold that lane of racks, there's nothing that prevents MVP from just farming a little bit more and then using all that team gold they just got from those barracks to just buy another item and make it just as hard as it would have been. Even if they don't have the Aegis, so... Yep, there's the Yules for Lush. Gonna go on.
They've almost finished the pipe as well. Like the Vengeful Spirit practically has it. The Nature's Prophet also now has his Aghanim Scepter.
Oh, speaking of that, simultaneous pickup.
Yep.
So you're playing one Rex down minute 23 against an Ags Prophet and a Bounty Hunter, and a Lich Rack that can just push in the waves all the time. Pretty hard, how to say. Some damage here though on MP.
And he yields the drum, trying to buy a little bit of space. BTs are coming in on the tree and some Poppy. Well, kind of felt like he was baited to come out to try and battle that one. Cure comes in also with Diffuser Blade charge is now available. And Poppy bought back instantly. He's happy to sacrifice his money. Misery gonna charge himself forward and keep for the opening. Get the lance just flying in. And Misery is under control for the moment too. Eternal Envy, man, a shuriken toss bouncing around everywhere. And Pilotized Relocate doesn't save anyone. In fact, Misery is already down. And Team Secret, can they stop this Korean train? I don't think it's even really possible at the moment. Eternal Envy just losing too much life. They swap Puppy back in again with the Thumb Disc. No Shallow Grave to try and buy any form of time. Eternal Envy dying underneath his own tier 3 tower like he's gonna toss Cure around, but it doesn't stop the epic. Rev kicks in, the trees are surrounding Weeha, he cannot bail out this one. Pilotai is just watching his own friends die right now. The Aegis might be reclaimed, but it's
game
GG.
Over, man.
24 MVP, not only do they 2-0 E-Home, they 2-0 Team Secret to take the number one seed out of Group A. What a cool series for them today.
Yeah, well, the Secret Draft was better, and they had a better chance, and they played better, and they still lost in minute 24. This team is looking really scary.